So hello and greetings to the all the viewers. Today we are going to see hydrostatic pressure application in a vertical as well as horizontal vessel using ANSYS workbench. So here like we will study how to apply this hydrostatic pressure. So if you talk about a pressure vessel industry, when we will going to design this any vessel or water tank, in that case it is you can say the mandatory to test it for a hydro test. So what they will going to do, they will fill that vessel up to top, or we can say up to top nozzle, by using working fluid, and they will keep it so that they will come to know what will be the hydrostatic pressure at the bottom of the vessel. So we will study in this presentation. We will start now. So this slide represent the learnings in this video. First we will see the small introduction to hydrostatic pressure, and then we will see how to calculate that hydrostatic pressure, what is the formula. Then we will see hydrostatic pressure variation with respect to height, how it will going to vary with respect to height. Then we will move towards our actual hydrostatic pressure application in ANSYS. There we will see for a vertical pressure vessel as well as for a water tank. Then we will also do the analytical calculation, and we will try to match with the ANSYS application. So this slide represents a small introduction to the hydrostatic pressure. So hydrostatic pressure is nothing but the pressure which is exerted by a fluid at equilibrium at a given point within the fluid due to force of gravity. So when we talk about hydrostatic pressure, it will going to be increased in proportion to the depth measured from the surface because of increasing weight of a fluid exerting downward force from above. The deeper the object is placed on the fluid, the more pressure is experienced. This is because of the weight of the fluid above it. The more the dense of the fluid above it, the more will be the pressure on the object that is submerged. This is due to the weight of the fluid. So when we give more and more deeper, you will find more pressure. You can see over here, that is almost this thing. And if you go to more and more upper, you will find the less pressure. This is due to the, because the gravity will going to play the major role in this case. So now we will see how to calculate this hydrostatic pressure. So this slide represents the formula for a pressure on an object submerged in the fluid. So we know the basic thing, like pressure is equal to force per unit area. So here the force will be calculated by using, this is like Newton's law of acceleration, mass into acceleration. So Newton law of motion, F is equal to M into G. So here like once we will calculate the force, we know the pressure. Pressure is also like force per unit area. So here we will put this value Mg by A, and density we know mass per unit volume. So the mass is equal to density into volume, right? So the pressure, when we put this in this form, density into volume into acceleration per unit area. So rho, the formula that gives the pressure on the object which is submerged in the fluid is like P is equal to, that is hydrostatic pressure is equal to rho gh. So rho is nothing but density of the fluid, g is acceleration due to gravity, and h is nothing but your height above the fluid. Of an height of a fluid above the object. Okay, so here you can see the density, volume and acceleration divided by area, and therefore you will get this kind of equation. So this is one of the diagram of water tank. Here you can see the at the bottom level the pressure is higher, and it is more, once they you will go move up, you will find the pressure is reducing, and here it is zero. Okay, we will see this now. So now the next question will come, like is we saw that P is equal to rho gh, but what exactly it is, whether h will going to play a major role, or where volume, or all these things. As if you see here, the height will be up to this, and you can find the pressure of 12,000 pascal, right? Once you will increase this height, you will find the some more increase in the pressure. Similarly, if you increase this pressure, height furthermore, you will find the pressure nearly 25,000 pascal. and if you make up to this, then you will find the pressure is 30,400 megapascal. So here it is clear that once you will increase the height for the same configuration, you will come to know that pressure is totally depends upon the vertical height of this fluid. Okay, then we will move towards our actual ANSYS part. There we will try to apply this pressure, and also we will try to calculate, so that we will come to know the major difference between analytical and the what value we are getting in ANSYS. We'll compare that. So now we will move towards our actual ANSYS part. There we will try to learn how to apply this hydrostatic pressure and how it will going to vary when we put the increase in a height. First you can cross check with the units and you can select as per your convenience, and then directly double click on this and your geometry will going to import. I had already created this geometry just to reduce our time. You can see over here and made some geometry cleanup, because our intention is that only to see the hydrostatic pressure application. So I will not going to spend much more time on this TM part. So if you see, this is what your vertical vessel, which may consist of manway, and this is your vertical nozzle. You can see at the top of this, and this is the tailing lug, which is supported by this saddles. Okay, so before going to this, you can put all the select all and put in a single part. I had already kept it that in a single part. Okay, now we will move towards our actual mechanical. So you just double click here, your geometry will going to be open like this. Okay, now the very first part is you can first cross check with the geometry. If there is any defect, then you can clear that in design modeler. And then contact here, like I have kept it in a single part, so there is no need to define a contact. Now we will do the meshing here. Like if you apply hydrostatic pressure, it will not show until and unless we haven't done any meshing. If you see this, right, first we will do the mesh. I will put insert sizing, so I will select all. So here, like I will just going to do the random mesh with higher mesh sizing, so that it will save our time. I just wanted to show how to apply this hydrostatic pressure. I will clear this data and I will generate the mesh. Okay, so now the file size is coarser, so it will not take much more time. And then once it is done, then we will move towards our next part. So if you see, okay, with this sizing it is not done. I will put some more finer mesh, 75 or 550 mm. It is actually bigger mesh size, but you just keep in mind, generate. When you will do actual simulation here, at least you should keep three elements across the thickness. Okay, so here should be like three elements, second order elements. It is mandatory when you do pressure vessel simulation. So here my purpose is just to show how to apply hydrostatic pressure, so that's why I'm not keeping finer mesh, and I'm going with the plate mesh also. Okay, once it is done, now we will quickly move towards our so this is what our standard earth gravity, but if you are applying hydrostatic pressure, there is no need of applying this. So what I will do, I will first delete this, and what I will do, I will first create the cross section, so that we will come to know the insight. Now we can apply a pressure. So when you just right click in this, insert hydrostatic pressure, and you can see this will be open like this. Once you will see this hydrostatic pressure, select the all the internal surface, extend to limit. You can use this option, extend to limit, and even you can select this portion also, right, because fluid, once it will be filled, then here also you will find some pressure. Now you can cross check units. I will keep as a material. Once pressure is it will ask for three inputs. First your fluid density, So our fluid, first we will going to put a crude oil, heavy crude oil, so that is having a density of 920 kg per meter cube, and our gravity is 9.8066 meter per second square. Here you can, it will ask you to define a dimension, direction. So here what I will do, I will keep by coordinates component, and here a vertical you can select 9.8066. Now you can see your pressure is applied, and here you will find the pressure will be higher here, but here the, if you see, the third point is your free surface location, so it is nothing but your height. So basically here height is you can see the triad over here, that is nothing but your global coordinate system. So it is at some distance from this. So if you see, or you can measure that height, you can measure that from design modeler. We will measure that height now. So if you see at this location, my height will be view. I will measure height one tool, analysis tool, distance finder. I will measure height between this low coordinate and between this point. So if you see, my vertical x height will be like this. Okay, so it is like 1.8 mm approximately. What I will do, I will open Excel. Here already I had mentioned, like our, if you see, density, hydrostatic pressure is nothing but rho gh. So density of crude oil 920, your gravity will be 9.80, and our height will be this. It is in mm, so that's why I will use as a 10⁻³. So it will be in mm meter. Now if you move towards our actual mechanical part, so here maximum I am getting for a height of here, it is, though it is showing zero, but this coordinate at this end, so from this it is height of 1.8 meter. So for that we are getting maximum value of 16,866 pascal newton per meter square. So what I will do, we will calculate that whether it will going to match or not. Rho into g into h, so if you see, so it is nearly what we are applying there, like 16,000 pascal, and here it also 16,000. Small deviation is there, but your all the major digits are matching. So like that, your analytical pressure, you need to cross check once again with this your ANSYS value. Now we will cross check whether it will going to vary with respect to height or not. So right now height is, so what I will do, I will put over here, and I will some increase one height further. I will increase second, and I will increase further more. So what I will do, I will increase in this plus 0.5, further I will increase in this plus 0.5, and so like that you can increase this plus 0.5, okay, and here like 0.5, 1 and 1.5, and we will try to match this rho g h. Similarly rho g second height h, similarly rho g and last one height. So we will try to match this value with our ANSYS. I think this value should be, and here, okay, so I will make it in general. Now we will try to match with our ANSYS. First height increment will be 0.5, so I will put over here 0.5. so with the first increment, what value I am getting is nearly 21,000, and here also it is like 21,000, right? 21377.9. And when we put a height of 1 meter, you will find also, see how it is increasing, 25,000 Pascal, nearly 25 I put, and similarly when we put 1.5, so you can see it's like 30,000, right? And here it is. So here the height is like 30,000, nearly 30,400, and here it is 20. Let me check something is wrong. If you add this, okay. So you can see here it is like 30,400. So the hydrostatic pressure is varying, right, with respect to height, and it is also matching in case of ANSYS as well as your analytical calculations. One more thing, that if you don't want to select complete surface, you want this much surface also, you can apply that according to your surface selection also, okay. And suppose the, if you want to consider this much portion also, you can apply over there also, right? Based on this height, it will going to vary, okay. Then we will do one more exercise, like here we had applied in a vertical vessel. What we will do, we will apply in a horizontal vessel, and then we will see is there any difference will come into picture, okay. Then what I will do, I will open quickly our another model. So you can see this is what that model I had. This is the model of a water tank, right? And you can see this is your top door location, this is saddle, and here it is pipe, which is basically at the down of this tank to collect the water from the, okay. This is fillers and this is collector, okay. What we will do, we will try to apply hydrostatic pressure in this case. Then I will open quickly the mechanical. Once your mechanical open, you just first check the geometry once, and then you can here like contacts are not needed because we are kept it in a single part, so I will suppress that. And you can define a respective sizing, select all, insert sizing. I will keep for a time being coarse mesh, okay. And this is what that hydrostatic pressure, I will tell you how to apply. Insert, right click, hydrostatic pressure, and here I had created, you can create a cross section first, and then you can select the inside surface. Here extend to limit you can use, and if you want here also you can apply, okay. Extend to limit and apply. Now as we know that water density, so the water density is 1000 kg per meter cube, so I am putting same, and I will put the acceleration further, right? So acceleration in a z axis, so 9.8066, and your height you need to match. But if you see here, it is not showing because the mesh is not done. So once your mesh is done, you will come to know. I will generate that mesh first, and then you will see the difference, and then till that time we will apply, we will try to calculate how to do analytically, right? I will copy the same part, Ctrl C, Ctrl V. Here the density of oil is like 1000 kg per meter cube, and height what we'll do, we'll measure the height of global coordinate from design modeler. So here it is global coordinate. So what I will do, I will measure that height. But how you can measure them? So tool analysis, distance finder. From this face, right? This phase 2 height or other body, I think this phase, and show all bodies. I will measure the vertical height. So the vertical height will be z axis 0.71. I'll put over here and we'll calculate rho g h. So this value should match with our answer's value. Okay, 7. I will height so if you see here, okay, and here it is 11,000, and what we are getting, so rho is this, this is this. I think height is somewhat, we need to cross check further height. So if you see, there is a difference in a height here, like different in a pressure. We here we are getting 7,000 and here it is 11,000. So it will be due to the height difference. So what we will do, we will further measure that height in a design modeler. Okay, then what I will do, tool analysis, entity information, and I will select this face. So if you see, the radius is 1.15 and it is at the half of that portion. So we will consider this radius and then we will come to know what is the difference. 1.15. okay, now if you see, it is matching. Okay, your analytical results are matching with the application. So that's it. Like here what we did, we applied a pressure, hydrostatic pressure, and then we just compare with the analytical calculation, and we also check whether it will going to vary with respect to height and not. So here there are like three important things: your density, your gravity, and your height. So that will going to play a major role for this pressure. Okay guys, so thank you. And here, like the once your simulation is done, there is separate criteria. If you are following ASME, you will going to compare these values with respect to allowable values, and the limits for allowable values are different. It is not as usual what we did for a plastic collapse simulation or a bioelastic approach. Here it is different in case of hydrostatic test conditions. So I will create one more video that is related to simulation of this vessel. In that case, I will apply all the dead loads and this hydrostatic pressure, in even the pressure load suggested by ASME, and then we will do the validation. For the time being, it is like I just wanted to show you how to check the hydrostatic pressure, because it is very important, and also need to check how much height is, how it is varying with respect to height. So thank you guys, thank you. That's all for the video. Please let me know your comments. I will be there to help you. Thank you once again.